Tom Reddicliffe this morning from GreenTech Metals. Tom, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Good to see you, Tom. Look,
Good
you've
to see you.
recently announced here some high-grade rock chip assays, these from your Osborne and Ruth Well projects. Just tell us a bit more about what you've seen so far.
Yeah, look, we came onto this project rather late in the day, but those samples were from our Kobe lithium trend, and which is about 7.5 kilometres long, as it goes across our Ruth Well project tenements and into the adjoining Artemis JV, or the Osborne joint, what we call the Osborne joint venture tenement, which we hold with Artemis. We're the operator and 51% interest. And those results really just underpin what we've sort of been, what we know about this lithium pegmatite, is that it, over the length of it, we can get +1% grades, whether you're at the western end or the eastern end or in the middle and so forth. It's a relatively consistent zone that's running through the countryside, east to west. And, it represents probably a fairly big mineralizing system for, to get some consistency in the grades over that length. And it varies in widths. It's not the biggest pegmatite, I suppose, but, 4, 5, 6 meters wide in parts and whatever. So, and we, the next step for us really is to put a drill hole into it, or it's several drill holes. It's quite a big target, and to see what's happening at depth. And that's usually the case for most of the pegmatites that are projects around in Australia at the moment. So, but there's the second project, of course, is to the south in the JV ground, and it's quite a little bit different. There's a couple of pegmatite systems there that are over 1 kilometer long. We're getting reasonable grades. Rock chips over them, and up to 3.6%, and collectively, there's probably about 4 kilometers of strike there. Now we would hope, not hope, but the last pieces of our planning are falling into place, and that we are confident we'll be able to. So we will be drilling very, very soon, okay, and we will inform the market as to when we're able to for that to happen.
Tell us a little bit more about what you're looking to do in terms of this drill program.
Look, initially, we want to see, mainly because it's a little bit hard to determine from the surface. There are packages of pegmatites there. We want to put a longish, what we might call a, for want of a better term, a stratigraphic sort of hole across them. And we're able to do this because we can do it from previously cleared drill sites that we've had. And we'll drill through, and we just want to see what sort of real depths, dips they have on them, and so forth, and how thick they are. We'll get some grade information as well, but we just need to get that type of information so it will help us with a follow-on drill program, probably follow up with assay, something like that. And we need to tweak that program a bit. And we'll use this information to do so. But it also gives us a good first look because this is diamond drilling. We'll get some nice intersections of pegmatite, we would hope, and because we can see these things outcrop, so we would hope that we're not going to miss them. And we'll be better informed, and then we'll roll, hopefully, without too much of a break, on into the next part of the program.
Just give us a little bit more detail, Tom, on the area itself and some of these other companies operating nearby.
Yes, look, where we are is, maybe 25 k's from where Azure made their significant discoveries. Now, I'm not sure we can join dots between our discoveries and theirs or whatever, but I guess geologically, the whole area is underlain by a quite a fertile source rock, granite there. That's produced all of this all the lithium, and it's got to be a big system, because you're looking, you can it's probably 40, 50 kilometers long, and I think the whole region in terms of exploration is very, very early days. I think we've already now demonstrated that the pegmatites, not only where Azure is, but down where we are. More recently, Raiden has picked up some stuff as well, associated with the Andover intrusion. So it's all good stuff. The area's open up, and it's in the past been overlooked, and great place, close to ports, whatever. We're only 20 kilometres from Karratha. A lot of infrastructure there, 2 hours out of Perth by plane. You know, it doesn't get much better than that. And, you know, it's relatively easy to work there. We have relationships with the local Aboriginal groups and so forth. So it's all good.
So near term, Tom, what should we be looking out for from you in terms of news?
Oh, look, I think in the short term, we will be reporting progress on drilling. Okay, and we still have some samples out there as well, but we're transitioning from the mapping and rock chip sampling stage. People want to see us drill, and we want to drill as well. And, you know, there's certainly things there a little bit harder to find, perhaps in terms of pegmatites to chase up. But our main game now is looking at and testing, you know, in that third dimension by drilling these pegmatites that we have. And we would hope that, you know, evidence is that they're big systems. So.
Really good to see you, Tom. Thanks for your time.
No worries, Andrew.